So Cam, I'm all done setting up my fantasy football lineup. Do you got some time to go into the inbox and just see if we have any good myths or anything that we can take a look at?
I actually just checked. We have a really good one.
Really? Tell me more.
We have a scientist who wants to know, quite bluntly, if guard columns actually work.
Seriously?
Yes.
That's a great one.
I hope they work
because we sell them. We hope they add some value. All joking aside, I mean, if you think about it, guards aren't used all the time. And if you're really using dirty samples, like we had shown in a past episode, mm-hmm. they can add some benefits.
Mm-hmm.
We should really take a look at this because we want to actually make sure that they do work.
Right. Well, it is actually a legitimate question when you think about it. I mean, I've talked to scientists who will avoid using them because they're worried about it affecting their chromatography. They're worried about it adding length to their run. You know, their analytical run, it can add some time.
Sure.
You know, and they do cost some money, right? So do yeah. they actually do anything? Are they actually worth the money that we would spend for them?
Jeez, I hope so. Let me get some guards.
Okay.
We'll get an analytical column or a couple columns,
mm-hmm.
and we'll do some testing.
All right, sounds good. Here we go.
So Kim, I found some guard columns. I actually pirated them from one of the cabinets over here. I hope nobody minds.
Mm-hmm.
And when you take a peek at these, because I'm not really that familiar with guards, they come like three in a pack, which is kind of cool. And they're these little kind of devices. I mean, they're kind of just like little analytical columns.
Mm-hmm.
So kind of neat. I also stole, or pirated, I should say, a couple analytical columns that we can use. So how do you want to set up the experiments?
Yeah, well, I think you've got exactly what we need. We can use two columns. We'll use one with a guard column and one without a guard column.
Nice.
So the one with the guard column, let's just inject large volumes of samples.
Yep.
We'll push it to the limit until we can't get good chromatography anymore.
Gotcha.
The other one with the guard column, once we hit a certain spot, what we can do is take the guard column off, put on a new one, and see if we can bring that back to the performance and back pressure that we expect to see. Then we know if the guard column did its job.
That's fantastic. And I already know the perfect dirty sample to use for this myth.
Oh, I bet you do.
So Kim, for a dirty sample, I once again took that danipril tablet.
Yeah,
and as recommended per the United States Pharmacopoeia, I just dissolved it up in a simple diluent here. And you can see this is pretty cruddy stuff here.
Again, perfect sample for this experiment.
Yeah, so if we do a few big honking injections of this onto those two columns, mm-hmm. one with the guard, one without, monitor the pressure,
yep.
we can see really how long it takes for those columns to kind of fail. So Kim, what can you tell me about the experiment we ran where we took a column without a guard and with a guard and did big injections of dirty sample on them?
So you can see here, what we did was plot both of those columns on the same graph. And you can see that the column without the guard column, the pressure went up pretty quickly and the column was just dead. We couldn't use it anymore because it was over pressure. But with the column that had the guard column, we were able to change the guard cartridge and bring the pressure back down to a reasonable level and keep running. Then once we saw the pressure start to rise again, we changed it again. And then we finally changed it a third time, and we probably could have kept going. So I think we can see that guard cartridge was actually really helping us with our analysis.
Yeah, that's perfect. We got about four times more injections just by swapping out the guard. So that guard really did add some value.
Whew, that makes me feel better.
This is a fun myth, Kim. Really good proof of concept. The guard looks to do what it was designed to do. How do you want to call this one?
Well, I think this one's absolutely trusted. I think a guard column, when it's installed properly on the system and in the column, can really help you get more lifetime out of your analytical column.
Excellent.
Yep.
Well, I'll write this customer back and say, look, if you have a real dirty sample and you don't want to filter it for some reason, a guard column is probably the best solution.
Fantastic. I'm glad we could prove that one.
Perfect.
If you'd like your question to be answered on a future episode, please feel free to email us at trustyourscience@waters.com.